Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
Hey there, it's Lisa Kay, and we are back for another episode of Between Heaven and Earth Radio. And today, our show is called How to Use Your Intuition to Make the Impossible Possible. Now, I have seen intuition make the impossible possible. This is like magic, especially when you want something so big and so grand that you can't see how it could happen. We all want things, whether it's wealth, better health, love, spiritual peace, or specific things like a house or a car. Now, manifesting is about creating or turning something from an idea into physical reality, or it's getting what we want. Sometimes what we want seems too big to happen, but with the magic of intuition, you can make the impossible happen. And in today's show, I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, this is all because your intuition is what guides you to just the right places, things, people, or leads you to do the right steps to make your desired manifestation happen. It is the key step in manifesting or creating what you want in life. And this is how to do it. Now, in episode 265 of my podcast, I talked about how we, as a family, my family, manifested a dream apartment for my son when he was looking to live near the university he was going to. This apartment turned out to be better than any of us could have hoped. And it all came about because we all did the following steps that I'm going to share with you. And I heard and followed my intuition. When the apartment we ended up buying all seemed impossible to get what we were looking for. So you can go back and listen to that episode 265 if you haven't listened to it, and you can hear the story. But this, as I said, has happened again and again. And when my son Chris was young, he had a passion for architecture. Actually, he had an architecture passion since he was 4 years old, when he was drawing floor plans with crayons and markers. He didn't know what an architect was then, but he always has loved architecture. And by the time he was 13, he was following architects that he loved, and most of them were from Scandinavia, especially Denmark. He wanted so badly to learn more about their architecture. And I told him, well, maybe you could do a summer internship in Denmark as a student. Now, after lots of research, unfortunately, it turned out that architecture internships were only given to college graduate students, and he was still in middle school. He was 9 years too young. Now, this was the case both in Denmark and here in the United States. It seemed impossible. So I said, it's okay, to Chris, just put it out to the universe and put it out there that this is what you want and be positive about it. And what that meant was to keep being passionate and loving that architecture. Be open and believe it can happen, and you might be surprised. Anything can happen, just let it go. I myself figured, well, you know, that might be a class might turn up or something may show up where he could go, who knows. I let it go too. Now, 2 years later, Chris came to me and he said one of his favorite Danish architects, Bjarke Ingels, was here in New York and he was giving a lecture in the city. And Chris asked if he could go. Well, of course, I said yes. And hey, we could all go. So my husband, Chris, and I went. Now, the day of the lecture, I remembered that Chris had Bjarke's new book. So I told him to bring it, and maybe we could get Bjarke to sign it. So we went to the lecture, which was wonderful. And afterward, they invited everyone to meet Bjarke at a special table that was set up for book signing. We were the first in line, and as we waited, I noticed the book had mostly dark pages in it with white type, which is not the best for signing. So I told Chris, what you do is you find a mostly white page in the book where he can sign and ask him to sign on that page. Bjarke came out to the table and sat down after he shook hands and briefly talked to a small crowd of people that was following him around. Bjarke greeted Chris and held out his hand to take the book. Chris handed them the book, opened to the page to sign, and asked Bjarke in Danish, can you sign on this page, please? Bjarke smiled and he took the book and started signing. Mid-sign, Bjarke suddenly looked up at Chris and said, obviously surprised, in Danish, you speak Danish? Now, Chris continued the conversation in Danish, and it went something like this, which he told me later. Of course, I couldn't understand anything he was saying. But Chris said it went like this. He replied, yes. And Bjarke said, have you ever lived in Denmark? No, I've never been to Denmark. Is your family Danish? No, look at me. I'm Chinese American. I'm not Danish. Do your parents speak Danish? Nope. I learned Danish from my friends on the internet. Wide-eyed, Bjarke then said, you must be a genius. And I explained to Bjarke after guessing what was being said in Danish, you know, Christopher wants to be an architect. He's been following your work, and he wants to go to college to be an architect. So Bjarke said to me, you must be very proud of your son. And I said, oh, yes, I am. Then Bjarke looked straight at me in the eye, and he said, you don't understand. Your son is fluent in Danish. Then the impossible thing happened. Bjarke said to Chris, you must come down and visit my office here in New York. Come and do an internship with us. And Chris did. In fact, he went back for a couple of summers to Bjarke's architecture near our offices in New York. Denmark came to Chris. Now, was it the universe that made that lecture accessible to Chris? Was it my intuition that told me to tell Chris to ask Bjarke to sign on a specific page? Perhaps if he hadn't, he wouldn't have had a conversation in Danish. So I'd like to think it all came together because of the following steps, the things that we did to make the impossible possible, to manifest the things that we want. So how do you make the impossible possible? Well, here are the steps. Number one, don't allow yourself to block the energy of manifestation because you want the energy of manifestation to create for you. And our biggest block is believing that you are not able to have what you want. So we need to believe that manifesting this is possible. It is better to believe it is already happening, that it is in the process of being formed by the universe for you. Believing it is already in place to manifest for you is very important. Number two. Now this is the fun part. You get to use your imagination. Imagine what you want is already reality. Your imagination is connected to the universe and your thoughts create reality. Don't overthink it, don't analyze it, just create a picture in your mind or perhaps create the thought or words about what it is you want. I'm already wealthy. I am wealthy. I own that car. I live in that home. This is your chance to create the dream. Just imagine its reality. Now, a good time for you to do this is just before you go to sleep. Now, I do this. As you close your eyes, getting ready to sleep, imagine your future dream. It's kind of like make-believe, where you create whatever you want. Now, again, don't overdo it with analysis or details of how it will work or how you can make it happen. Don't do that. Just forget that part. Just imagine the end result. Imagine what it would feel like and enjoy it. Number three, release it to the universe. Now is the time to let go, even forget about it. You've put in, quote, your order. Now just allow it to happen. Just like when you order at a restaurant, you put your order in and you forget about it because you expect it to show up later, and it does. You'll be presented with inspiration, synchronicities, intuitive messages on what to do or where to go next that can lead us to the final step. And that final step is to use your intuition. So this is number four. Now, your intuition comes into play to make your manifestation more efficient. Remember, you are co-creating with the universe. That means when the universe comes to you with opportunities or events, people or assignments, take notice. You will find people, things, events, and situations may arise that are in response to your manifestation request of the universe. And it's your intuition that helps you notice the right ones to follow. So you check in with your intuition to determine what things to pursue. For example, someone may come to you with an offer or an invitation that requires you to take action. Or maybe you come across an event that seems in line with your requested manifestation. You might find yourself drawn to something, drawn to the event, drawn to take an action. Now beware, your thinking might say, oh, you don't have time, or maybe not now. But that draw, that feeling, that intuitive feeling is telling you something. These things that come up are most likely new since you're manifesting what you don't already have. Check in with your intuition. Does it give you a good gut feel? Is it light and enticing? Does it have energy? If so, go with it. So you can start practicing today, manifesting and using your intuition to guide you to the perfect next steps and opportunities that the universe is presenting you to make your manifestations come to fruition and become reality. You can start small, like manifesting a wonderful meal or perhaps a concert tickets. Who knows? Allow yourself to believe and feel the excitement of knowing that what you've requested is coming to you. Then let it go and be open to the messages that might come by, the situations or incidences that come up that seem to be, again, linked to your request. You know, perhaps a friend calls out of the blue and you find yourself trying to decide whether or not to call them back. Call back. You never know, they might be inviting you to a concert that you wanted to manifest. So take the next day or so and figure out what you want to manifest. Practice, play with it. Then to put the steps in place to let it happen. Manifestation may take more than a day. In fact, it might take weeks or months. But continue to have that faith and be on the lookout for those synchronicities. Use your intuition to see what you're drawn to or what pops up. So let's go over those four steps again. Number one, believe it can happen. Believe it is in the process of coming to you as reality. Number two, imagine what life could be like with it manifested already and have fun with it. Number three, let go. Release it to the universe and forget it. And number four, be on the lookout for synchronicities and be aware of your intuition. It may be pointing you to the next important step to take to have it become reality. When we looked at that apartment that wasn't for sale, my intuition said, this is it. This is the one. And it became reality, and better than we could have ever imagined. When it was impossible to get an internship in a Danish architecture firm, or any architecture firm at 15, it became a reality. So there it is. That's how to make the impossible possible with your intuition. If you like this podcast, please give us a review on iTunes. Go to betweenheavenandearthradio.com and you'll see a link there to put in a review. I would love for you to do it. I read every one, and it certainly helps our podcast get out to the world. All right, that's it for now. Thanks for listening, everybody.